explorers! Welcome to the magical world of heroes! Have you ever wondered who the greatest heroes in history are? They're not just people who fought battles or wore capes. They're people who changed the world with their ideas, their kindness, and their courage. Today, we're traveling back in time to meet a great thinker, doctor, and scientist, Avicenna, also known as Ibn Sina. Are you ready? Let's go! The life of Ibn Sina, the boy who loved to learn. A long time ago, in the year 980, a little boy named Ibn Sina was born in a small village called Avicenna, near the great city of Bukhara, which is in today's Uzbekistan. His full name was Abu Ali al-Hussein ibn Abdullah ibn Sina al-Balhi, but most people just called him Ibn Sina. Ibn Sina is known as Avicenna in the West. His father, Abdullah, was a wise man who worked as a scholar and a government official. His father was originally from Balkh, but later he settled in Bukhara. Bukhara was the capital of the Samanid Empire at the time, and a city that rivaled Baghdad as the cultural capital of the Islamic world. Their house was always filled with important thinkers who talked about philosophy, science, and mathematics. Thus, Ibn Sina became familiar with science and philosophy from his childhood. From the moment Ibn Sina could talk, he was full of questions. Why does the sun shine? How do plants grow? What makes people sick? He never stopped asking, and his father encouraged him to learn as much as possible. By the time he was 10 years old, Ibn Sina had memorized the entire Quran. But that wasn't enough for him. He wanted to understand the world, so he studied many different subjects. He read about math, astronomy, and philosophy. But what interested him the most was medicine, the science of keeping people healthy. At just 16 years old, Ibn Sina was already treating patients. He became known as a brilliant doctor, even though he was still a teenager. People traveled from far away to see the young boy who could heal the sick. One day, the ruler of Bukhara became very ill. No one could cure him until Ibn Sina stepped in. Using his knowledge, he treated the ruler and saved his life. As a reward, the ruler of Bukhara gave Ibn Sina access to the royal library, one of the largest collections of books in the world. Ibn Sina was overjoyed. He read everything he could, learning more and more every day. Ibn Sina's love for learning never faded, but when he was 22 years old, his father passed away. And soon after, the Samanid Empire collapsed. This meant Ibn Sina had to leave Bukhara and find a new home. He traveled across many lands, stopping in cities like Urganj, Marv, Nishapur, and Khorasan. Wherever he went, he continued to study and teach. He shared his knowledge with students and worked as a doctor, helping those in need. Eventually, he settled in the city of Isfahan, where he worked as a scientific advisor and a doctor for the royal court. He even participated in battles, healing wounded soldiers. Despite his busy life, he still made time to write books and study new subjects, including literature and philosophy. Ibn Sina believed that the human soul was very special. He taught that our minds and hearts are connected, and that learning and kindness make a person truly great. His ideas about the soul, knowledge, and morality became famous throughout the world. Ibn Sina wanted to share his knowledge with the world, so he wrote many books, about 200 in total. One of his most important books was called The Canon of Medicine, which became the most famous medical book for hundreds of years. In this book, he explained many things about the human body, diseases, and treatments. He was one of the first people to understand how diseases spread through air and water. He also explained how the heart and blood work together, and even described how to test medicines before giving them to patients. Doctors all over the world used his book to learn how to treat people. In Europe, his book was taught in universities for over 600 years. Even today, some of his ideas are still used in medicine. Ibn Sina also helped develop early painkillers and anesthesia, which made surgeries safer. He even worked on treatments for mental health, helping people who struggled with their emotions. Avicenna was one of the brightest minds that existed during the Islamic Golden Age. He thought a lot about big questions, like how our minds and souls work. Avicenna believed that when we are born, our souls come into the world with our bodies. He said that our bodies are like tools that help our souls learn and experience life. As we grow, the things we learn and the good habits we develop make each of our souls unique and special. He also tried to show that thinking logically and believing in something greater can go hand in hand. His ideas helped many people understand themselves and the world better. Ibn Sina's work didn't just help people in his own time, it changed the future. His books were translated into Latin, the language of scholars in Europe, so that even people far away could learn from him. For centuries, doctors, scientists, and philosophers studied his writings. His knowledge helped shape the way hospitals were built and how doctors treated patients. That's why today, people still call him the father of medicine. But Ibn Sina's story isn't just about medicine. It teaches us something even more important. Curiosity, hard work, and kindness can change the world. Despite his brilliant mind and endless curiosity, Ibn Sina's health began to decline in his later years. Even though he was a great doctor, he could not cure himself. After a lifetime of learning, healing, and teaching, he passed away in the year 1037 in the city of Hamadan, now in Iran. But his knowledge and ideas never faded. His books continued to guide doctors for centuries, and his legacy still lives on today. No matter where we come from, if we ask questions, keep learning, and help others, we can do great things, just like Ibn Sina. Maybe one day, one of you will become a great doctor, scientist, or philosopher, and make the world a better place. The end. That's all for today's adventure, young explorers. If you liked this story, don't forget to like and subscribe for more amazing tales about heroes from history. Thanks for watching, and remember, keep asking questions and never stop learning. See you next time!